the women. You can see
This is the woman that speaks French.
So Nikki, just explain what each picture of the calendar is portraying and what month or time of the year it relates to. The ones with water, we say that was the rainy season. The ones with snow, we say that was when it was really cold. The cold season began. So there are verses that relate to it, even though they don't know the specific days or days of the week or the actual months as we know. But they have their own calendar that goes with the moon. So this is just in addition. They're very thankful and they really like these things. And we told them to eat these in a communal place to put them up so everybody could see them and look at them and enjoy them. And that they were mainly from our friends that went to the American school in Switzerland that wanted to say that the work here was really good and that to encourage them to keep on working hard. And they said they really thanked you for all your support.
Thanks a lot to everyone in Switzerland from the people of Hankura. Okay, it's the same day, April 5th, 1994, and we've just finished the meeting. And now we're starting to teach people how to make the stove. We put the three rocks down on the ground so that the pot would sit on it very well. The pots, they'll make the food in. And the stove will always have to be used for this pot. Now they're making the brick. Lee, how does it feel? Next, we put the little bricks down. Here we are, moving out the mud that we've just put on to try to form a cook stove. We have the pot still in the middle, and we'll pull that out later, and we'll cut out the doors and little vent holes. But right now, everybody's just smoothing it out. We've made little bricks, we rolled bricks, you can see, from the mud. You roll out bricks and you lay them all on top of each other
around the three big rocks that we picked up. So, we'll see what happens from here. We try to get the women to participate as much as possible because the idea is they're going to go out into other concessions and teach other women how to do it. So if we end up doing all the work for them, or if men get involved, they'll often be the ones that do all the work, because men and women sometimes have difficulties working together. So we try to get women involved as much as possible, because we want them to see it as a women's activity. Meet the big cook pot to make sure that we'll be able to, that it's the right size, that there's enough space in between the rocks and where the cook stove will rest for there to be wood put underneath and a good fire to be made. Then we'll leave it alone for a while, let it dry, and go do a couple of more, maybe in another concession. Provided they've pulled the dirt and clay, have that already. But after it dries a little bit, we'll come back and put vent holes and doors in it. But for now, this will be enough here, I think.
Okay.
So here we are, hours later, a few stoves later, coming back to cut the doors and poke the vent holes. This is the president of the women working on the first one that we did. We finished this one for outside for her to do her rice or 2-0, and inside we just made one for the sauce. Okay. This is the sauce one that we just finished inside of the house. This is Hawa's house. Just a bunco hut with a thatch roof. And a tiege bed, and that's a masa iron that she'll put on the one that we just, on the stove that we just cut the door on out that on the outside, kind of like pancakes. So now the door is completely cut, and we're putting the wood in to make sure it'll fit.
Okay, today is April 7th, and it's about 4:30 in the afternoon right now. And we're in the village of Talambu, which is about 40 km away from Lee's village, which means about 60 kilometers away from Bangui. And we're here with some people from the Service of Agriculture, the government service, who are going to help us cut a deal for the peanuts, for the peanut project. So we thought we'd film a little bit of that, and you could see how that works.
Okay, these are the peanuts.
They're checking out the quality. How is it?
Very good.
Is it ameliorate?
You can definitely tell by the taste, it's very ameliorate.
Thanks. Now, these peanuts are supposedly better quality because they get done faster. They take 3 months in the ground as opposed to 4 months. And they also produce more per plant. So I think we're going to get these. And we're going to get 10 of these sacks. These big sacks, they're 40 kilograms each. And so that'll be four women sharing each sack. Be speaking to them now.
No, sanda da ni duma latifo latimar jini gudu dini dusa.
Pudu pudu sa. Iku baca ba asin da bangkang hangkam bay. Apa tu pudu sa? Apa yang bisa warangka?
Sak apa aku hai latu warangka?
Dan dulu nang kuhanu. Anda beri kita.
What's he saying, Lee?
He said that if you get a new field and maybe you put, what do you call that, like fertilizer, traditional fertilizer in your field, then one big sack like that, you can receive a product of 20 sacks.
Wow.
So that would
be... And the traditional would be how many sacks?
Manti Amelia one though. Isaino one though. Send a one kind of email, right? Send a traditional one. Do me the traditional. Agahai, send a latifo agahai latimoja. There's otra.
Arashid. So, zangada one niki dan nudi mas latu falang naga du warka kini latu warka kini.
Sendi nadi ma. Ndo mo kap umbayi ko awasula sa tuon. Apo yung bodo dangala to warangka kindi kaya
kini. Si de gros bus. Donc ça remplit facilement les sacs. Mais les gars peuvent avoir jusqu'à 22. Mais maintenant en valeur, ça dépasse l'autre. Même à la vente quoi. Ça là, ça coûte plus cher que l'autre, le prix d'achat.
Parce que ça là, c'est plus la teneur est plus élevée en huile.
Parce que généralement, les gens qui achètent ça, c'est les femmes qui font de l'huile. Bon, et les femmes préfèrent ça là, cette variété à l'autre.
We're paying 5,000 francs each for these sacks, which is about $10 maybe? We are at the house of the chief of the agricultural service here in Bangu. And we're at his house right now, and he's going to introduce himself. Comment est-ce que vous vous appelez?
Maman Moutari.
Okay. Et ici, nous avons qui?
Ici, c'est Régi.
Mm-hmm.
Régi Moussa.
Uh-huh.
Ici, c'est Abdelkader.
Okay. Merci. Petite sœur de qui?
C'est ma petite sœur.
Oh, c'est votre petite sœur?
Oh, oui.
Ok, elle s'appelle comment?
Elle s'appelle Saudi.
Saudi. Téléphone quoi?
Allô.
Ok, donc, qu'est-ce que vous faites ici?
Je suis en train de faire un rapport là.
Uh-huh.
Un rapport d'activité.
Ok.
Oui.
Et quelles sont vos activités?
Premièrement, je suis un agent de vulgarisation.
Mm-hmm.
Donc,
vulgarisation, c'est quoi?
Vulgarisation, c'est-à-dire que je donne des conseils aux paysans.
Mm-hmm.
Donc, dans le cadre des activités agricoles,
mm-hmm.
pour pouvoir permettre aux paysans d'améliorer leur production.
Ok.
Hors des activités de vulgarisation, je suis chargé également de la partie protection des végétaux. Donc pour les activités de protection des végétaux, on a la formation des brigadiers
mm-hmm.
au niveau donc de 20 brigades qui sont formées.
Mm-hmm.
Donc c'est 5 brigadiers par village.
Mm-hmm. Combien de villages?
Il y a 20.
Okay.
20 villages. Donc, ou 20 brigades.
Uh-huh.
Donc au niveau de chaque village, il y a 5 brigades.
Mm-hmm.
Ils s'occupent des interventions phytosanitaires, c'est-à-dire le traitement des cultures en cas des attaques.
Mm-hmm.
Donc en dehors de ça, je suis également chargé de mener des activités statistiques, c'est-à-dire pour les enquêtes prévision de récolte.
Mm-hmm.
Pour une évaluation des productions au niveau donc, de la zone. En dehors de ça, il y a le contrôle de marché pour connaître également les prix des produits. Donc, au cours de la semaine, pour voir l'évolution, donc le cours de produits s'effectue une seule fois par quinzaine. Donc, soit dès le mois, deux jours de relevé, quoi. Donc, particulièrement, je ne peux pas parler du Niger, mais je peux parler quand même de ma zone.
Ok.
Puisque ici, les problèmes qui se posent au niveau de ma zone, c'est un problème de fertilité.
Mm-hmm.
C'est-à-dire, il y a une baisse de fertilité au niveau des terres des exploitants. En dehors de ça, il y a des problèmes d'approvisionnement, puisque les structures ne sont pas fonctionnelles, étant donné que les paysans, même s'ils ont de l'argent pour payer l'engrais, l'engrais n'est pas disponible. Ça, c'est des problèmes qui se posent donc au niveau de cette zone. En année, nous avons eu à travailler en collaboration avec...